Welcome to the course CS353 Grid Computing. We are in module 4 and this is the second lecture of this module. Today we are going to discuss about MyProxy, which is a credential repository system built for grid computing. We need two lectures to complete the description of MyProxy. We will discuss the basic background of MyProxy in this lecture and the actual implementation will be discussed in the next lecture. To prepare this slide, I am following these two resources or two references. One from the book The Grid Core Technologies by Mauzen, Lee and Mark Becker, and another one I am following a paper, research paper, which was published in the year 2001, an online credential repository for the grid, MyProxy. Okay, I strongly recommend that you should read this particular paper to know more about this talk. Okay, so this is our syllabus for module 4. We are not going to discuss all these things, the detail of this. We'll directly go for the discussion of MyProxy. We know that a grid service, if you see this figure, a grid service is actually accessed through grid portal by a user. So a grid portal are a common approach. So it is the common approach to providing user interfaces to different grid applications. Okay. Generally what happen, we will not directly send the request to grid portal. Actually, a user uses a browser. Okay, that means in between a grid portal and the user, there is a browser is there through which the request came, and the browser sends that request to grid portal for accessing the grid resources. Browser gives a simple graphical client, right, to access these grid applications. But whenever the security concept is, we think about the security concept and we are using the concept of web security protocol, that web security protocol says that he does not support the concept of grid portal. That means standard web security protocols employed between a web client and a server do not support the need of grid portal. Okay, that is one issue. And the second issue is, generally what happen, as a user we delegate our service or we treat grid portal as a delegate to access the grid services. Delegate means this is a replacement. Grid portal is a replacement on behalf of us. Means if I am a user, on behalf of me, grid portal act as a delegate who will actually initiate and monitor the operations for me. That means all the requests that I want to perform or all the tasks I want to perform, I will first employ a grid portal as a delegate for me, who has all the credentials, means the credentials like the authentication credential, and he use that credential to access the grid services. Okay, and that is the most important part of this application. Okay, so this point is most important. Most grid portal requires that the user delegate to the server the right for that server to act on the user's behalf in order to initiate and monitor operations for that user on the grid resources. So as I have already discussed, that grid portal act as a delegate for us who will initiate and monitor all the operations. Okay. Now these grid services is actually where it is present, means who protects this, who protects these grid services for authentications. So that is the concept called grid security infrastructure. So all the grid resources are generally protected by the grid security infrastructure, which is a component of Globus toolkit, and that has become the de facto standard for grid security. Okay, so grid security infrastructure is the standard for providing grid securities. In the previous slide, we discussed that grid portal acts as a delegate to access the grid resources, and GSI supports that. So GSI supports such delegation. What delegation means? GSI supports grid portal as a delegate for accessing the services, but we are using the standard web service security protocols, but the standard web service protocol do not support this. So the standard web security protocol do not support this. That's why this leads to an incompatibility between web and grid security, which must be overcome in order to enable the smooth operation of grid portal. Okay, so to operate grid operation smoothly, we need to find out a solution for it. Why? Because delegation is supported by GSI, but web security protocol do not support that. That's why another solution is developed, that is called MyProxy, which is designed and developed in order to bridge this incompatibility between web and grid security, thus enabling grid portal, enabling grid portal to use the grid security infrastructure protected resources in a secure and scalable manner. That is the need of MyProxy comes into picture. Okay, so before we are going to discuss about MyProxy, the detail of MyProxy, let us first understand what is GSI, how GSI maintains the security, means what we need to access the grid services through authenticating through GSI. So grid security infrastructure. So what is GSI? GSI is a set of protocols, libraries and tools that allow users and applications to securely access grid resources. That is the definition of GSI, and the GSI system is based upon public key infrastructure. I hope all of you know public key infrastructure in your previous course as network security. I only explain the terms which are associated with the explanation of MyProxy. I will not go in detail of public key infrastructure, how it is built, how the digital certificate is generated, what is the role of private key, what is the role of public key. All these things are coming under public key infrastructure. I may create a separate video for this whenever we are going to discuss about grid security. But for the time being, what are the terms associated with PKI which will be used in MyProxy, that I want to discuss. Okay. So let us start. So what is a public key infrastructure? Public key infrastructure, in a public key infrastructure, all entities, now you assume that you are a user, so you are an entity, are identified by a globally unique name known as DN. So you are a user and you will get a DN, which will be uniquely identifiable throughout the world. In order for entity to prove their identity, when entity or a user who want to prove their identity before accessing the resources of grid computing, they will get a grid credential, obviously. So they have to possess a set of grid credential consist of a certificate and a cryptographic key, which is called the public key. So two things he need, one certificate, another one is called a private key to access the grid credentials. I mean, this is act as a grid credential. So where do they get the certificates? The certificate is nothing but the certificate is a binding of the DN which was assigned by your PKI infrastructure, the DN and your private key. By binding both these value, we will get a digital certificate or certificate. That binding is done by a certificate authority, that is CA. It is a global authority. It is the global authority who assigns the certificate to all the security related issues. Okay, that's all about your PKI. Now GSI uses secure socket layer to implement authentication, message integrity, and message privacy. So a secure socket layer will be maintained by your GSI for the authentication, message integrity, and message privacy. Okay, and also it says that the GSI uses the credential for authentication, means PKI credential. I have already explained what are the PKI credential you need. So those PKI credential can be directly used for authentication and is used in GSI without modifications. So without modifying that credential, we can use directly with the GSI to access the grid resources. In the grid environment, a user may need to authenticate themselves multiple times in a relatively short period of time. For example, if multiple resources are being coordinated. So what does this mean? The meaning is, let us say you are the user and you access through your portal to the grid resources and you need multiple resources maybe. So this is your resource R1, this is resource R2, this is resource R3. So you need all the services of all these resources. So whenever the portal is trying to register with R1, he need the credential to allocate R1 to you. Similarly, when he trying to the services of R2, he need the authentication credential. Again, R3 also need the authentication credential. That means every time the portal try to access the resources, every resources needs that credential. So if portal is if the portal is trying to ask you many times that please provide your authentication detail that is provided by your PKI credential, and you know that PKI credential, there will be a private key, and generally private key are not shared multiple times. It may be used immediately and it has to be stopped using in a frequent amount of time. So you will be reluctant to share your private key for registering all these resources. So that is the main problem. So that means you need to tell the portal that you use any authentication process that can be used to access all these resources. So portal will be act as a delegate for you. Should not provide your private key multiple times whenever he is trying to register for a resources. Okay, so that's why this point is discussed over here. Okay, so requiring the user to repeatedly type their passphrase, as I have already told you, requiring the user to repeatedly type the passphrase for the multiple authentication is clearly undesirable. Okay, it also undesirable from the security standpoint, as each time their private key is decrypted, because you have to provide your private key, then it has to be decrypted according to the rule of PKI. So if you continuously provide your private key, there will be a chance that somebody will get your private key and will misuse that private key. That's why it is not useful or not good to share your private key multiple times. That's why if portal will be able to get your user ID password in some manner, and he will use that user ID password when registering with the resources, then you will be relaxed for that. And other issues, you cannot share the private key. That is also another issue. So let us, what the solution for that will be? So that's why the solution will be, we have to use a proxy credential. Proxy means it is not the actual credential you are going to use. So GSI, your grid security infrastructure, solve this problem with proxy credential. So what is a proxy credential? A proxy credential is a short-term credential that is created by a user, which can be used in place of long-term credential to authenticate that user. So what is a long-term credential? The long-term credential, which is actually generated by your CA, the digital certificate and your private key, everything. So that part is your long-term credential. You will not share these things to other. Okay, means you share the certificate, but you will not, you are not allowed to share your private key. Out of that long-term credential, if you can prepare a short-term credential which is built from this long-term credential and act as a proxy credential for you. Generally, this proxy credential will be generated for some hour or for some day. It will be the lifetime of that credential will be very low. That I have written in the next step. Because a proxy credential is more vulnerable to compromise, they are typically given much shorter lifetime. So, and then the user long than the user long term credential, usually on the order of hours or day. So generally this short term credential or the proxy credential is more vulnerable to the security issue, that's why vulnerable to compromise, that's why they are built for very smaller time. Got it? That is called the maintenance of a proxy credential from a long term credential. Another point where we want to discuss is delegation. As I have already discussed, delegation means I have to delegate in the sense I will create the user ID and password for smaller amount of time delegating to a particular server. So let us read this point and it will be clear to you. Delegation is very similar to proxy credential creation. So we have to create a proxy credential. In that, an existing set of credential is used to create a new set of proxy credential that is identical in function. Means as I have already discussed that short term credential will be created from long term credential. Delegation means the same thing. Means from the existing credential, what exists with us? I have a private key and a certificate, digital signature certificate and a DN. So by using that, if I could able to create or delegate a small credential, which will be the lifetime is smaller, then that concept is called actually delegation. Right? The difference is that the creation occurs over a GSI authenticated connection, with the result being the remote process acquiring proxy credential from the user. Okay, so that means it will be created in the the creation will be done with GSI authenticated connection. So when you get the connection, you started creating that user ID and password for a short period of time. That user ID and password will be sent to your portal. The portal will keep that user ID and password, and when he register any resources for you, he will use that credential, and he will not ask you multiple times about the credential values. Okay, that solves our problem. That's why this is that means we can say that whenever a user access the resources, he will create a short-term credential and provide it to the portal. The portal will use that credential to access many resources. It may require many times the credential for that, but he will not disturb the user to provide the the original credential. So that temporary credential will be present in a particular server. That server will kept it for maybe 2 days, maybe 2 hours or 3 hours, and it will be get disabled. Okay, so by using that, the problem of authentication will be solved. So how the MyProxy works, we will discuss in the next class. Thank you.